Hey, you guys, what's up? We're going to go ahead and just jump into your reading. Okay, so first things first, it looks like some of you have basically stopped being as nice as you used to be, if that makes sense. So maybe the people that will resonate with this reading, maybe some of you guys used to be like people pleasers, or maybe you would just give more than you were getting. You know what I'm saying? So some of you guys are starting to think like, hold up, I can't keep giving when I'm not getting. You know what I'm saying? So a lot of you guys throughout your lives maybe realized like you were just giving more than other people. And I feel like some of you guys just got tired of this shit and you're like, yeah, so this is what we're not gonna do, okay? So I feel like a lot of you guys are just giving less. You know what I'm saying? Because I feel like you either gave to someone in the past or you gave to people in the past too much. And I think that some of you guys regret doing that, you know? Maybe it took you guys a while to stop this behavior of just maybe being too kind or being too giving. It took you a while. Maybe, you know, after people kept trying to mooch off of you or people kept trying to take from you or people just weren't treating you well, after so many times, you guys were just like, all right, you know what? I tried being nice. I tried being a kind, giving person, but apparently that is my downfall right now, you know? And I'm not saying to be a mean person. I'm just saying some of you guys realize being too nice could be an issue, okay? Or being too giving could be an issue, okay? I feel like some of you guys, well, the people that will resonate with this reading, I feel like you haven't had a serious relationship or a real serious freaking commitment in a while, okay? Yeah, some of you guys are just very focused on you and basically your goals and just bettering your life right now. Some of you guys, maybe you're not going out as much. Maybe you're just basically doing you, you know? You're doing you. I just heard introspection, so a lot of you guys are just like, all right, what can I do to better my life? What can I do to better myself? And I'm gonna, you know what I'm saying? Like, you guys are thinking, like, how can I better myself? How can I better my life? So let's see. Yeah, a lot of you guys see your potential. You know that you're bomb, and you know what you could do in this world, in this lifetime, you know? So maybe in the past, some of you guys just weren't doing all the things that you wanted to do in this lifetime, or you weren't going for exactly what you wanted. It's like, I'm just feeling like I could do better. I could do more. And that's just what I'm feeling, okay? So in the past, maybe you were just weren't doing as much as you want to be doing, okay? I do see that you've had, okay. So there is someone who could be a little bit toxic. Maybe this is someone you were dating or seeing. This is someone who's about to be coming in and communicating. So definitely a good heads up right here. So basically these cards are saying just to be expecting that someone is about to be coming in who isn't the best for you. Basically that's it, okay? For very few of you, some of you guys, maybe this person was good intimately and stuff, but it's like, other than that, they're pretty toxic, you know? Some of you guys, this person could be good looking. I think this person, something like they took a while to come in. Maybe it's been a little bit, it's been a while, but they're definitely coming in. It's like they've gotten mental clarity that some type of third party or another option that they were seeing, it was just hurting them. It was just bringing them down. It was just destructive, you know? And now this person is over here like, how was I even unsure about, you know, this person and you? How was that even a thing? So this person ended up getting very hurt with this third party situation. Yeah, I feel like this person hurt you. And it's just saying that they're about to be coming in any day now, any week now. They're literally on their freaking way. Okay, so it is saying that, listen, if you allow this person, whoever this person is, right, you're about to find out, unfortunately, but whoever this person is, it's just saying that if you don't leave this person out in the cold, you could definitely expect to stay feeling stuck, to stay feeling, you know, shitty, not good, you know, not progressing, not focusing on yourself. So This is what I'm seeing, okay? And it's definitely 100% saying, do not get intimate with this person. And some of you guys are like, yeah, that would never happen, blah, blah, blah. But it's like, listen, the future is the future, okay, babe? So just listen up, do not get intimate with this person. And really, it's saying to not really communicate with this person. So yeah, it's definitely saying right now, it's time to just focus on you and your goals and your plans, okay? So it's basically saying, like, listen, this person made a decision to go with some other person. Like, and you had to stay stuck and think about it. You know what I'm saying? And it was just shitty. It sucked. While this person was out here with this third party. You were over here defensive. Like, what is this person, what does this other option have over me? How are they better? What did I do wrong? This person had you over here thinking about what you did wrong when you did nothing. Yeah, I feel like this person has thought about, like, coming to you and just trying to patch things up because they're in, like, this severe regret. Yeah, this person wants to come in. They're very stressed out because they feel like they ruined this. And, of course, they want to patch it up, but they just feel like they ruined this. They put it on fire, like, watched it burn, and now they want it back. Do you know what I'm saying? So this person's very stressed out, feeling like they literally just ruined this, you know? All for this third party who didn't even work out in the first place and crushed them. Anyway, they thought this third party was the stable option. This was the real deal, right? Absolutely not. They found out the hard way. Look, I feel like this person and this third party, one of them was very sneaky. They were constantly lying, and there was always, like, this fighting, this arguing, and these trust issues, and, like, it was always something, like, you know what I'm saying? If some of you guys have been in a relationship or dated someone where you cannot trust them, that is the worst. I feel like both of them were probably sneaky and lying to each other at some point. This is very just toxic, just disgusting energy, you know? And this person is just holding on to this, like, I let go of the best thing for literal trash, you know? So definitely kicking themselves. Damn, you know what I'm saying? All right. Okay, so basically, yeah, this is what this is saying. Basically, these people were trying to work on a relationship or a situation, and one of them was literally acting single. Or maybe both of them. But I'm seeing that they're acting single, sneaking and lying. It's just a whole mess. It's just a whole mess, babe. And one of them was very materialistic. It could have been the person that they were going for. Like, they were just acting single, doing whatever they wanted. They were very materialistic, all about the money, materialistic things, okay? So, yeah, the cards are just saying, like, look out, this is incoming. But you guys have amazing things coming in for you. You guys have, like, a huge purpose, okay? A lot of you guys are extremely special, and you aren't just meant to just be here la-di-da-di-da. No, you guys are meant to do something in this lifetime that's big. You guys have a freaking purpose, okay? Some of you guys could be moving or getting a new job that's gonna make you very happy, okay? Or maybe this already happened. But a lot of you guys, I'm telling you, there's something freaking special about you guys. Let me show you, okay? Here's the Star card, and this is the biggest pentacle in the deck, okay? Spirit needs you to know how special you are, and that you're here to literally, like, some of you guys are here to change the world, I'm hearing. And that could be by doing things that seem small, like being a nice human being or being kind, or I don't know. Obviously, with everybody, it's something different, but you guys are special. And obviously, like, everyone's special, but I'm just feeling like there's something here. I don't know what words to use, you know, but listen, I think some of you didn't realize who the hell you were in the past, and it took a lot of healing in order to realize, hey, I'm a freaking king, or I'm a queen, you know what I'm saying? It took a lot of maybe pain, hurt, lessons. So yeah, going forward, I see some of you guys are not as nice and giving as you used to be. And like I said earlier, like, sometimes being too nice and too giving will hurt you, you know? Because a lot of people are out here like take, if not most people, or at least in my experience, okay? Let's see. Yeah, it's like, I just heard some of you guys were very nice and giving, and then that made people think that they had one up on you, which is very sad and kind of disgusting, honestly. Okay? Let's see what this is about. Yeah, I feel like your life is just about to be getting better. I see you working on something, whether this is yourself or a job, a career, and I see just you genuinely being like happier, either now or in your future. Things are just gonna be going really well, almost too well, and you're just like, damn, like I'll take it, but things are just seeming perfect right now, okay? So I'm seeing a lot of good cards, honestly, okay? And you are about to be realizing that there's someone that's going to be coming into your life, okay? So some of you guys might have already met this new person, or you're going to be meeting this new person, but I'm definitely seeing a relationship. I'm seeing equal give and take, and I'm seeing like these intense emotions for one another, and spirit literally set you guys up. Like you guys are meant to be with each other. So this is definitely beautiful. So you're going to be having a victory in this relationship, okay? And basically spirit saying you deserve this relationship. You deserve this healthy, amazing relationship, because it's like there was a point in your life where you almost had to start protecting yourself, and you had to like change up some things, you know. You had to change up the people around you, and maybe the way you were in ways, you know, like I said, being very nice, being very giving, maybe even people pleasing at times. I feel like there was a point in your life, like I said, you were like, all right, you know what, I gotta protect myself, I gotta change some shit up, and then you started doing that, you know, introspection and healing and working on yourself. And spirit's just literally saying, whatever you did, whatever work you've done, listen, here's your justice. And your justice is going to come in many ways. I'm seeing a lot of good karma, like I said, just plain old like good ass cards, happy cards. But other than that, I'm seeing this love interest coming into your life, and spirit saying, listen, you deserve this, you deserve this. You stayed strong throughout so many things, okay? Two different decks, strength card, here you are. You've been through a lot, and you're strong as freaking hell. Yeah, I'm seeing, I don't know what you guys had to end. Like I said, whether it was people, whether it was things you were doing, you know, you ended something, you ended multiple things, and spirit just, it, like, they want to gift you with something. They want to give you good karma, and they want you to know it's because of the decisions you've made that you're about to be receiving all of these things. Yep, look, love incoming. Maybe you guys weren't aware of this, but now you are. Yep, spirit's saying, hey, like, we're making shit happen up here, and things are about to go very well for you, okay? Yep, look, soulmate energy, King of Cups, Queen of Cups, boom. Soulmate energy, why? Because you did the healing, and this is what you're about to receive because you deserve it, okay? I feel like if any of you guys, maybe some of you guys are not dating, some of you guys are dating, but I'm seeing multiple options around you that are interested. I feel like you're guarded towards these options because you're over here like, nah, I deserve the best and I'm not just going to settle. So I'm like, you guys are over here looking for like the best. You're not going to settle at this point. So yeah, I just see you looking at these options like, yeah, well, I got to find the best. Okay. So definitely a new, beautiful cycle. Let's see. Yeah, some of you guys, maybe there was a point in your life where you went through a depression, or you just weren't feeling like happy. You weren't feeling happy feelings. Okay. But I feel like now in this new cycle, it's just completely freaking different. It's completely different. Like I said, I'm seeing just the wish fulfillment card, happy. Like, yeah. And some of you guys do deal with anxiety, but you guys are strong as hell. Like, it doesn't matter if you deal with anxiety. It doesn't matter what you've been through. Like, you guys still are over here like, all right, so how can I better my life? How can I be a better person? Okay. And I feel like, because right at the end, it's kind of just saying this person who's going to try to come back into your life, who hurt you very badly and was keeping the third party and stuff, like, they're going to be getting a lot of bad karma. And I feel like a part of their karma is losing you. Okay. So they made a rash decision or whatever. And maybe this is to teach them, like, hey, like, your actions have consequences. Shit, like, you know what I'm saying? Okay, let's go ahead and see what else is coming through for you. What else is going on with you guys, just in general? What else is going on with you guys? All right, we're going to go ahead and pull the first card right now. What is this? What the hell? Okay. All right. First things first. There is someone, okay, this is a good caution, good warning. There is someone out here that you guys need to kind of be aware of, okay? There's someone who could really, like, take advantage of you in regards to, like, finances or trying to mooch off of you. And this could be in any way. Like, this could be, like, mooching off of you for rides or... it could be literally anything, you know what I'm saying? But I'm definitely seeing some type of warning, whether this is someone in your life now or someone who's going to be coming in the future. There's someone who's going to be like trying to get money from you or trying to mooch off of you in any way, shape, or form that they can. Maybe this already happened, but I'm just seeing someone who will literally use the shit out of you financially. And like I said, that could be in the freaking form of rides. It could be in the form of money. It could be in any way. But I'm definitely seeing this as someone you need to, like, look out for, okay? Some of you guys already know who the hell this person is, okay? It's definitely clicking for you. But it's just someone who is going to take advantage of you. And they know exactly what they're doing. So don't feel bad for this person, okay? This person is no good for you. No freaking good. I just keep hearing mooch, mooch, mooch. What can I get out of you? What can I get out of you? And this is what you guys have been trying to get away from. So yeah, definitely realize this now and definitely think about this, okay? Because this is very real and this is happening, okay? So it's like this person is going to come in and like act like they have something to give when in reality they're just here to take. Okay? So just a little warning there. This person will only cause you stress and will just try to... Okay, I don't know how else to say this, but just to say that this person knows exactly what they're doing. They know exactly what they're doing. And if this isn't resonating, it might just resonate in the future when someone comes through, whether it's through dating or a friend or a freaking family member. I don't know. But it's someone, right? This person... they know what they're doing. They know what they're doing. And I keep hearing, don't feel bad for this person. They know what they're doing. They're taking advantage. They're freaking wrong. I'm sorry. This is kind of resonating with me over here. So I'm like, you guys. Ugh. So hard to find genuine people. Like, it's so freaking difficult. So definitely be defensive towards this sneaky, lying-ass person, okay? Definitely. What is that word? I don't know the word. Anyway, it's like they just know what they're doing. Anyway, and you've just come so far. Like, you've done so much healing. You've done so much to balance out your life, and you're such a strong human being. It's like, and no matter what you've been through, you're still a strong, nice human being. I'm just saying, like I was saying earlier, you're just not as giving and people-pleasing and, you know. And this person is about to test the shit out of you. Are you going to still be a people pleaser? Are you going to still give until you can't give anymore? Because this person is going to try to take it from you. Ugh. Yeah. And then if you allow this person to, like, screw with you, you will end up regretting it afterwards. Like, oh, why did I do that? I let someone take advantage of me. Don't let it happen. Damn it. All right, anyway. There's very few of you, I feel like I need to say this, there's very few of you that maybe used to, like, smoke and drink or, like, some type of drugs or something, and maybe you quit or maybe you're trying to quit, but it's just saying, like, this will only lead you to feeling stuck and hurt and you will never progress, so there's really nothing good out of that, okay? And that's just for very, very few of you, okay? Like, there's nothing good that's gonna come out of that. And it might seem fun now, but it really ain't that much fun. Because what's more fun is working on yourself and seeing the progress you're making, saving your money, and seeing that money stack up. Like, that's fun. And that shit makes you feel good as hell. Okay? Going to the gym, seeing the progress. Like, hell yeah. And you're not doing it for anyone else. You're doing it for you. And that's what feels amazing. Okay? Whew. Okay, what else? Yeah, and I just keep seeing that, ooh, there's multiple energies who are trying to come in for you. But this one energy who's been going back and forth if they should come in or what they should say, I feel like this is the same person who hurt you in the past, kept the third party open. I mean, kept that third party. They're totally trying to come in and make things right with you, so caution. Okay, but you're going to be over here working on things with someone else, whether it already started or whether it's about to start. You're going to be out here working on things with someone who makes you extremely happy. And it ain't someone who's going to try to freaking mooch off of you either. Okay? So, yeah, I just see you head down working on yourself, feeling amazing, feeling like a king, feeling like a queen, you know, progressing. And then boom, this person comes in, they have an offer for you, and they're ready to treat you right. And it's like right when you stop looking, right when you're just, you know, looking at your own stuff, looking at your own life, boom, new person comes in. Okay? So let's see. Yeah, this person's going to be your wish fulfillment. And it's like, no one's treated you this well before. Okay, this person, they're going to constantly be complimenting you and telling you how they feel. They're not hiding it. They don't feel like sharing their emotions makes them, you know, because I feel like people from the past, they didn't tell you how they felt. They didn't give you as many compliments because they didn't want you to have one up on them. It's very immature. It's very egotistic. But this new person, they're not, you know, in that energy of like that. You know, it's like they're going to want to put you first. They're going to want to make you feel amazing. And they're not going to think like, oh my God, like maybe I'm gassing her or his head up too much. Like that is so damn toxic. Okay. What is this about? Okay. It seems like, okay. So you guys ever go on a date or you meet someone, right? And you're like, yeah, I don't know if that would ever work. Probably not, right? And then it ends up working. I feel like that's happened to me so many times. It's like, you'll just be like, nah, I would never be interested in that person. And then boom, like a couple months later, you guys are hitting it off, you know? I feel like that's what's gonna happen with this newer person. It's like you meet this person and you're like, yeah, okay, you're cool, whatever, you know? You're not over here like, we're gonna spend the rest of our lives together, you know? But I feel like you are though. Like you are gonna be spending your life with this person, yes. Yes, baby, here it is. This is incoming, and I've been getting this in my reads, okay? So, what's the, yeah, someone's not going to be so happy that you're over here happy. Uh-uh. It's like you're going to be living this stable life. You're feeling stable, balanced. You're doing good financially. It's like you have this love interest coming in. You know, your mental health is freaking good. And maybe when you were with this past person, maybe you weren't completely, you know, together. Like you weren't where you are now or where you're about to be. I don't know, I just feel like you're doing really good. You're progressing at a really fast pace. And you're just happier. You're about to be just happier in general. And there's some type of anxiety or stress that's about to be ending or coming to an end. So maybe there was just like some type of stressful period in your life or like a depression or just something wasn't going completely amazing. Or maybe you just weren't feeling as great and what's the word? Like motivated. But I feel like with this new cycle, you're going to be feeling motivated, you're going to be feeling good, and you got this lover coming in. Yeah, I feel like some type of conflict or some type of craziness is just coming to a freaking end, finally. And of course, this is having to do with your decisions. So let's see. Yeah, babe, be expecting this person that we already spoke about. They're no good, and that's just the truth. And this is for the people that are resonating with this reading. It's just like, I feel like this is just a big warning because I just hear, I'm literally hearing in my head like, wee woo, like freaking alarm is going off. And I just feel like, okay, honestly, I feel like most of you guys have like gone through most of the healing from this. So it's just like, damn, why open that door up again? I feel like some of you guys are going to be like, wait, are you dead ass serious? What is going on? When this person reaches out, you're just like, what? Like some of you guys can't even believe it. Like, you can't even believe this person has the balls to, like, do this. I don't know. I just see you guys looking at this person like, you gotta be literally shitting me right now. What do you want from me? Holy shit. Like, I feel like this person put you through hell. And then you had to, like, heal by yourself. And here they are trying to, like, crawl back in. Yeah, be expecting this any second now. Any freaking second now. Ooh, I got another soulmate energy. Soulmate energy. Both of you guys are going to be doing extremely good financially. You and this new person, okay? And you guys are just going to be motivating each other, okay? So it's not like someone who's just going to bring you down and make you feel less motivated. Like, nah, this person's going to make you feel motivated. They're going to be like, yeah, you freaking go. Both of you guys are going to amp each other up and just be the best for one another. Like, I love this energy. I'm not even going to lie. And it's like, I feel like you were not expecting this, or you were not expecting love to be this amazing, because all it was in the past was shit, okay? So this is just so new to you that you could have never even fathomed that this was gonna freaking happen. Yeah, you're literally guarded towards how happy you're about to be. You're like, how? How did everything turn out so freaking perfect? It's amazing. And I'm so freaking excited for you guys. Use your intuition because this commitment is coming through. Yeah, people from your past, they didn't want to give you enough. Boom. This new person's about to show you what you have been missing out on and what you've deserved this entire freaking time. So yeah, you might look at the past and be like, oh my God, I could have had someone like this new person this whole time. But I was settling because I didn't even know this new person or someone like this new person existed. I didn't know that someone could treat me this good. I really freaking didn't. So this person's about to show you some things, okay? Yeah, I feel like, you know, some of you guys have been single for a while, or like I said earlier, like you haven't had a serious commitment in a while. So this is going to be great. This is your justice. Like I'm saying, you did something to deserve this, okay? I'm constantly seeing like, this is your justice, this is your justice. It's some type of good karma. Yeah, in the past, it's like you weren't getting what you wanted out of love or relationships. Like your wish fulfillment, what you wanted was not happening, okay? And all whenever you dated someone, I'm seeing that all they did was bring in literal stress. Like, damn, that shit is done. Now it's time to celebrate, okay? So all this time you were with these other people that weren't treating you good and you were just going through life not having the best of the best. It's like all you were doing was thinking of, I just want the best. I just want someone who's going to treat me good. Like, does this even exist? I don't even know if it exists. Yes, it exists.